guys, this is David Kwan here, and recently, I think about a week ago, the media has been in a kind of a frenzy or a kind of excitement. Some people are really like, whoa, and some people are really upset that Stephen Colbert will be replacing David Letterman in The Late Show next year in 2015. So my opinion is, I'm kind of like, I don't know what to make of it just yet. Some part of me is pretty excited, but some part of me agrees with this article that was written, in which talks about how this move for Stephen actually is like Stephen becoming a king of a shrinking mountain, you know, because Stephen Colbert kind of really created this thing, Colbert Report, which is a very innovative show where he stays in this character of a right-wing kind of idiot, and that character is the show. He is such an self-important guy in that show. Like, what are, like, Stephen Colbert said it best in one of the interviews he's had, where anything that happens with Stephen Colbert, that is the news. Stephen Colbert is the news in the show, where other news outlets, you know, they're a conduit to the news. So that was an interesting thing that I thought that Colbert himself brought up. So, and when he replaces Letterman, you know, Letterman also was someone of an innovator when he started this Late Show. But now, being handed this down, this show, he's going to be a talk show host among many other talk show hosts. Now, it's pretty much guaranteed that Stephen Colbert is going to be an amazing talk show host because he's a very talented individual. I've always admired and respected Stephen Colbert for that, just because of the talent he has as a comedian, as a speaker, and just overall this persona, this charismatic guy. You know, I think that's an amazing thing that he deserves all the credit for. His show is not particularly to my liking. That's not kind of my humor that I like. You know, when I used to watch as a kid, I used to grow up on, like, you know, Tonight Show. And Conan O'Brien was like my favorite at the time in junior high and later in high school. You know, I would wait, I would go through Jay Leno just to get to Conan O'Brien. That was like my thing. You know, I think Conan O'Brien is usually talked about as this guy who is beloved by college students who are in, you know, who are suffering from insomnia. But in college, I didn't really watch any of that. I really used to watch that as a high school student. So That's what I got to. David Letterman, I really wasn't that into, but looking back, I realized, like, he's actually a really pretty talented guy, too. I just think his just kind of humor is not really my style. You know, he has his, I think his stick is just looking disinterested, or he's kind of bored. And that's kind of a stick. It's always been his thing. Whereas Conan O'Brien is kind of like this snarky, egotistical, and sarcastic, and really awkward, you know, and nerdy kind of thing. Although I think the more nerdiness now goes to Jimmy Fallon, I think. But in any case, you know, I loved Conan O'Brien, and Jay Leno was kind of just going through to with that. As far as the Comedy Central kind of talk show goes, I really resonate more with, like, Jon Stewart, you know, kind of self-deprecating humor and just kind of being like, oh, I just said something, and oh, did I really say that, you know, that kind of thing. Where Stephen Colbert is kind of more like important, self-important, kind of arrogant, but that's his character, which I think is really great. Now, this video, really, I want to talk about Stephen Colbert being out of character, and there are a lot of those moments recorded online, and you could kind of check out those moments on YouTube and on different various articles. I didn't really know, you know, I haven't watched too much of those kind of clips, but I'm really impressed. The two clips that, like, really have me like, whoa, Stephen Colbert could be, like, such an amazing guy if he didn't have any kind of creative restrictions, like I'm sure The Late Show may have, in which case that would be really disappointing. But imagine if Stephen Colbert ever became, like, a serious journalist and not just, like, this comedian. I think that would have been quite powerful. I think it's a good thing that Stephen Colbert is moving out of Colbert Report, because I think he's capable of doing so much more than just this kind of one-dimensional persona that he's able to. It started, you know, the character archetype is very one-dimensional, but the talent of Stephen Colbert that he's been able to make it into something more. You know, that's something that he's able to churn out 4 days a week for 8 years going straight. So that's amazing testament to Stephen Colbert's talent. But also, like, when he's out of character, there's this political gabfest that Slate has hosted. And Stephen Colbert came up with his own gab about Richard Nixon and how, Nixon's kind of dishonesty to the public was such a humongous deal in his time. And it's such an amazing way he kind of talks about it and the knowledge that he brings to the table. I also watched this interview that Eric Schmidt, this head honcho guy at Google, had with Stephen Colbert. Him talking about a whole bunch of different things from his publication, you know, the book that he published, America Again, Rebecoming the Greatness That We Weren't. And him just talking about that. Him talking about, like, what it means to be out of character and whatnot. And so that was a very, like, fascinating insight to what Stephen Colbert can be out of character. And I'm just really, really amazed by that, you know. And I know that Colbert, like, he actually doesn't like being self-important himself. And so this persona that he created, Stephen Colbert, is kind of like an opposite of him. And so I always think that's pretty interesting. It's almost like, you know, Colbert copes his insecurity with a character who doesn't have insecurities. So that's powerful stuff, I think. I'm very excited to see what happens with, after David Letterman retires and Stephen Colbert takes over. I know Stephen Colbert is going to be hosting that, like, out of character, like, as himself, but it's going to be interesting. He's a very talented interviewer. The fact that he can interview, like, the most intimidating people on planet with this kind of persona in character is an amazing thing as well. And I don't think even, you know, between the two, between Jon Stewart and Stephen Colbert, definitely Colbert is the more talented one, I would say. I just resonate more with Jon Stewart with his more, it feels more authentic and genuine. But that's to be expected because Stephen Colbert is in character. But the way he kind of, I think there's kind of a missed potential here. I just want to see, like, what would happen if, you know, Stephen Colbert, like, had the full creative freedom to do whatever he wants. And of course he came out with the Colbert Report as an end result, but, like, as him being himself, you know, or just completely different character altogether who's not just a parody or a satire. I think that would be quite an amazing thing to see. So that's really all I wanted to say. I just wanted to, like, bring a whole bunch of praise and respect to Stephen Colbert. I'm kind of disappointed that he'll be doing the Late Show, but then also kind of excited because it does give a chance to see him out of character. I'm pretty sure his wife is happy. You know, I know that I've read that his wife is not a big fan of Stephen Colbert, the character. So now Stephen Colbert finally will be, in after a year, will be having that chance of not having to be that character. So that's probably something for his wife. But yeah, that's what I wanted to say. What do you guys think about Stephen Colbert in general, I guess, and him being out of character, and also, like, you know, his taking over the Late Show? If you have any comments or questions, leave it down in the comment section below. I will happily read it and discuss things with you. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.